President Biden held a crucial summit with Russian President Vladimir Putin. Even before that meeting, critics of the administration say its policies are projecting a perception of weakness to America's enemies. Dale Hurd has more.
At the G7, Joe Biden announced America is back as a world leader. But some believe his administration's policies are making the world more dangerous. Biden entered the White House set to ride a post-COVID economic boom and correct what Democrats consider Donald Trump's reckless foreign policy. But after a series of setbacks at home and abroad, Biden has been dubbed the master of disaster, who is taking America back to the dark days of Jimmy Carter. High gasoline prices and inflation have returned at home, but critics say far more problematic is the perception among our enemies abroad that America is weak again. As Joe Biden makes good on his promise to roll back Donald Trump's foreign policy, it certainly doesn't feel as if it has made America or the world safer. North Korea greeted the new administration in March by firing missiles into the Sea of Japan. The White House response was basically, don't do that again. That same month, China mocked and humiliated the U.S. delegation at a summit held on U.S. soil. The White House has decided to reopen talks with Tehran over the Iran nuclear deal and even lifted some economic sanctions, which some experts say will increase the chances of a future war between Iran and Israel. And it resumed hundreds of millions of dollars in U.S. aid to the Palestinians, 1 month before Hamas fired rockets into Israel.
And every one of those rockets might as well have Joe Biden's name written on the side of it, because it is his weakness, his appeasement, his moral relativism and ambiguity, his lack of backbone to stand up and stand with Israel that is causing this war in the Middle East.
Frank Gaffney was an Undersecretary of Defense in the Reagan administration, which had to rebuild America's foreign policy after the disastrous Jimmy Carter era.
I would describe Joe Biden's foreign policy as basically Barack Obama's on steroids. I mean, think about this. A little over 100 days ago, Israel was in a totally different position than it is now. And that's 100% because of the Biden foreign policy mistakes.
The White House has also decided to cancel America's Keystone Pipeline and 10,000 jobs while allowing the completion of Russia's Nord Stream pipeline to Western Europe, something former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said Sunday the Trump administration would have never allowed.
We made clear that that pipeline was not going to be completed. It would not have been completed had we had four more years. I'm very, very confident of that.
Many Republican senators are also showing concern over changes the Biden administration is making to Middle East policies, particularly when it comes to Israel. In a letter to the president, lawmakers led by Senator James Lankford are urging the president to take a firmer stand with this key ally. CBN News Capitol Hill correspondent Abigail Robertson takes a closer look at the specific policies the group finds so troubling.
Senator James Lankford says when it comes to U.S. support for Israel, the Biden administration is sending mixed messages, and he argues we need to reaffirm our commitment rather than distancing ourselves.
We stand with Israel, their ally, and America is opposed to terrorism.
One concern is the Biden administration's decision to reopen a Palestinian consulate in Jerusalem.
That's an important way for our country to engage with and provide support to the Palestinian people.
Lankford argues it sends the wrong message.
Our embassy is in Jerusalem. That's the focus there. Obviously, the Jewish state is their main headquarters, their Knesset. All their leadership offices are in Jerusalem. That should be a focus. So I have real concern that sends a mixed message from the United States.
Add to that message plans to reopen a PLO mission here in Washington. Lankford worries that could potentially have a negative impact on fighting terror.
Though I've worked very hard to be able to allow victims of terrorism that are Americans to also hold Palestinian leadership accountable in American courts. And the connection there is if they base any of the Palestinian efforts here in the United States and have a headquarters here in the United States, American families are able to sue Palestinians for damages and for loss for the acts of terrorism that have been carried out against some of these families.
Langford fears the administration is trying to find a way around that.
And definitely shouldn't send a mixed message to American families that are victims of terrorism that they're not going to be able to get their day in court.
Secretary of State Blinken also recently announced $30 million in U.S. tax dollars will go to the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestinian refugees.
I do not believe we should have restored the funding to that UN organization that handles refugees. They handle refugees in the Palestinian areas different than they handle refugees anywhere else in the world.
Even Blinken recently acknowledged the UN group spreads anti-Semitic education materials, erasing Israel from maps.
We need to make sure the schools are actually not teaching hatred and bigotry to the next generation.
And Langford argues the group is not working to resettle the Palestinian refugees.
And the UN will not allow the Palestinians to be able to integrate in other areas because the theory is that they're going to move back to Israel and they're going to take over Israel in the future. That's absurd. Their focus there is to be able to drive the Jews out of Israel and have that not be a Jewish state anymore. That's not going to happen and should not happen. But that UN organization seems to be focused on that issue.
The Biden administration, however, insists support for Israel is strong.
Our stalwart support, our ironclad support for Israel will remain.
Republicans are also concerned with the Biden administration's plans to rejoin the Iran nuclear deal, arguing Iran is funding terrorist enemies of Israel like Hamas and Hezbollah. Reporting from Virginia, Abigail Robertson, CBN News.